Hello everyone, welcome back to the Aspentech Channel, and in our lecture series on the chemical reaction engineering topic, we are bringing the lecture number 4 to our valuable viewers. So in today's course coverage, we will start again from the chapter number 1, but we will solve the last problem, the last example, example 1.2 of that chapter, and that will wind up our chapter number 1. Then we will move to the chapter number 2, which is conversion and reactor sizing, in which first we will discuss about the conversion, and then we will derive the design equation for the 4 industrial reactors, and we have derived the mole balance equation for these 4 reactors in our previous lectures. So just having a recap of lecture number 2, that for a system volume V, where the entrance flow rate or the inlet flow rate is FA0, the outlet flow rate is F of A, the generation is G of A, we have write the mole balance equation in minus out plus generation is equal to accumulation, and that we write it as FA0 minus F of A plus integral R of A, which is the rate of reaction, D of V is equal to dNA over dt. In the lecture number 3, we have derived the mole balance equation for the 4 reactors. The batch reactor was derived in lecture number 2, but the other 3 was derived in lecture number 3, and we have seen that the batch reactor is spatially uniform but unsteady state. CSTR is steady state, spatially uniform. PFR and PBR both are steady state but spatially non-uniform. And the mole balance equation of CSTR is in algebraic form, while that of the other 3 in differential or in integral form. So the last example of this chapter is that consider the liquid phase cis-trans isomerization of 2-butene, which we write symbolically as A goes to B. That A is reacted and B is produced. The reaction is carried out in tubular reactor or the plug flow reactor and is first order with respect to the A, which is the limiting reactant. So we will write the rate of reaction equation as minus RA is equal to K of CA, where K is the specific reaction rate constant, C is the concentration. Now you see here that at V is equal to 0, which represents the inlet point, the start point, the concentration of A is CA0 and the volumetric flow rate is V0. Once it is exiting the reactor, where the volume is V1, volumetric flow rate is small v, and the concentration here is 0.1 times of CA0, means 0.1 times of the initial concentration. For example, the initial concentration is 10, then the final concentration will be 1. But if you see this line, that states that the volumetric flow rate V is constant, V is equal to V0, so that V is equal to the V0. The volumetric flow rate remains constant during the process. So we have been asked to do the 3 tasks in the system. Number 1 is to sketch the concentration profile. Number 2, we have to derive an equation which relates reactor volume to the entering and exiting concentrations of A, which means CA and CA0, the rate constant, which is K, and the volumetric flow rate V0. Once we have derived that equation in terms of volume, we have been given the values. Like we have been given CA is equal to 0.1 times of CA0, the value of K is 0.23 per minute, and that of the volumetric flow rate is 10 cubic decimeter per minute. So now moving on to the concentration profile. In our previous lecture, once we were discussing about the PFR, we have seen the profile of flow rate, that the flow rate of A, which is a reactant, decreases as it passes along the length of the reactor, while that of the B, which is the product, that increases. In the same way, the concentration profile will be built, that on x-axis we have the volume, on y-axis we have the concentration. The starting point will be CA0, which represents the concentration of the limiting reactant at the inlet of the reactor. And the final point, which represents volume as V1, the final concentration will be CA, and that will be equal to 0.1 times of CA0 as we have seen in the problem statement. So that concludes our point number 1. Now moving on to the point number 2, which is the derivation of equation. We know that the mole balance equation for the PFR or the tubular reactor is dFA over dV is equal to RA. Then we know that as per the rate law, since it's first order, so minus RA is equal to K of CA. Then we know that constant volumetric flow rate, as we have been given in the problem statement, so V is equal to V0. So what we will do, we know FA is equal to CA into V, concentration into volumetric flow rate, and that V is equal to V0 as per the problem statement. So that will become a CA V0. Now substituting FA over here, and what we will get dFA over dV. FA becomes CA into V naught. V naught is a constant term, so that will come out of the derivative, and that will become as V naught dCA over dV is equal to RA. Now we know RA is equal to minus KCA or minus RA is equal to KCA. So we will multiply this equation by negative sign, minus V naught dCA over dV is equal to minus RA, or that will become minus V naught dCA dV is equal to KCA. Now we have to take volume at one side and the other quantities the other side. So what we will do, we will simply take that dV over here and that KCA over here, and we will rewrite the equation minus V naught over K dCA over CA, because that will be integrated and that is equal to dV. The constant terms are taken out of this bracket so that the integration can be taken place easily. So next, integrating, lower limit is at V is equal to 0, CA is equal to CA naught. At V is equal to V, which is the upper limit, CA is equal to C of A. Equation will becomes minus V naught over K, that will come out of the integral. Integration CA naught to CA dCA over CA is equal to integral 0 to V dV. And finally, we get V is equal to V naught over K, natural log of CA naught over CA. So that is the equation which we have derived in this part. Alternatively, we can write the equation as CA is equal to CA naught exponential of minus KV over V naught if we have been asked to write equation in terms of the final concentration of the reactant. Now we have got this equation mathematically. So we have been given V naught, we have been given K, we have been given CA. You can see here that the given data is the volumetric flow rate is 10 cubic decimeter per minute. The value of reaction rate constant is 0.23 per minute. And CA is equal to 0.1 times CA naught. So substituting the values over here, the CA naught will cancel out with the CA naught, 10 over 0.23 natural log of 1 over 0.1 or 10. So accordingly, volume will come out as 100 cubic decimeter or 100 liters. So 100 liter volume is required in the system to proceed or to reduce the concentration of A from CA naught to CA or 0.1 times of CA naught and to proceed the first order reaction in the process. So that concludes our chapter number 1. Obviously, there are problems in the book which are mentioned, and you can solve this, and if you find any difficulty, you can contact me via the comment section. So now moving on to the chapter number 2, which is conversion and reactor sizing. But again, it is part of our building block number 1. And what are the objectives of this chapter? First, we will define the conversion. Then we will rewrite the balance equations for the 4 types of industrial reactors which we have written in chapter number 1. In chapter 1, we have written or derived the mole balance equation for batch reactor, CSTR, PFR and PBR. And here in this chapter and today, in fact, we will write down the design equation or equations in terms of the conversion. Then we will move on in the upcoming lectures and we will see how to size the reactors, comparison of CSTR and PFR sizes, and the best arrangement for reactor in series. So let's assume a generic reaction in which A of A plus B of B goes to C of C and D of D. You can see that the small a, b, c, d are stoichiometric coefficients in the process, while capital A, b, c, d are the species. Small a is associated with capital A. This represents that this species has a stoichiometric coefficient of A, B has a stoichiometric coefficient B, and accordingly C and D. But once we talk about the limiting reactant, or once we choose a limiting reactant, we have to make its stoichiometric coefficient as 1. So what we can do, we can divide it by that factor. Like we will divide here by A, and then we will get A plus B over A into B goes to C over A into C plus D over A into D. So the limiting reactant is actually the basis of calculations. Now the question arises, how can we quantify how far a reaction proceeds to right, or how many moles of C are formed for every moles of A is consumed? So a factor which quantifies it is called as the conversion in the process, which says that moles of A reacted divided by the moles of A fed to the system. That represents that how much the reaction has proceeded or how much the reaction has gone to the right side. If the conversion will be lower, the lesser will be the product form. If the conversion is higher, the more will be the product form in the system. And for irreversible reactions, the maximum value of conversion is 1, while for irreversible reactions, the maximum value of conversion will be the equilibrium conversion. Now, we will derive the equations for batch, CSTR, PFR, and PBR. First, we will start with the batch reactor. We know the mole balance equation, dNA over dt is equal to RA into V. Then, conversion is moles of A reacted divided by the moles of A fed. For example, if you have this reactor where NA naught moles are fed to the system and the outlet are N of A, then how much reacted, that will be described by subtracting NA from NA naught. Obviously, NA naught will be higher, NA will be lower. So NA naught minus NA over NA naught, and accordingly, rewriting that equation, we will get NA is equal to NA naught minus NA naught X. Now, we have to differentiate this equation with respect to time, and once we differentiate it with respect to time, this factor will become 0. So as you can see, this factor has become 0, and that will become minus NA naught X over dt. Now, that part is equal to RAV, or we can simply say that NA naught dx over dt, take negative sign with R of A, so NA naught dx over dt is equal to minus RA into V. And if you remember that we have derived the mole balance equation in terms of time, so taking time at one side and remaining quantities at other side, so dt is equal to NA naught dx over minus RA into V. So what will happen over here? We will integrate it. So the integration is lower limit is at time t is equal to 0, x is equal to 0, and at time t is equal to t, x is equal to x. So we will get the final equation t is equal to NA naught 0 to x dx over minus RA into V. So that is the final equation for the batch reactor, which is, we call it as a design equation. Now moving on to the CSTR, we know the mole balance equation is V is equal to FA naught minus FA over minus RA. We know that conversion is for this reactor, because it's a continuous reactor, only one reactor is batch, which is batch reactor, other reactors are continuous. So X is equal to FA naught minus F of A over FA naught, and FA is equal to FA naught minus FA naught X. So what we will do, we will simply replace FA over here with FA naught minus FA naught X, and what it will become, V is equal to FA naught minus FA naught, this will minus minus plus FA naught X, this FA naught will cancel out with this FA naught, and finally we get V is equal to FA naught X over minus RA. And we have introduced a new term over here, exit. Now, why we call it exit? I'm leaving this question for you, and in the next video I will talk about it. But before that, I would suggest that you read why we take minus RA at exit. Now, moving on to the plug flow reactor, we know the mole balance equation dFA over dV is equal to RA. Similarly, writing FA is equal to FA naught minus FA naught X, derivating it with respect to V, this term will be 0. And you can see, because it's a constant term, and X will be dx over dV. So minus FA naught dx over dV, that will be equal to RA, or we can combine these two, this one and this one, to get FA naught dx over dV is equal to minus RA. And if you remember that we have derived this equation in terms of volume, so taking volume at one side and dV is equal to FA naught dx over minus RA, simply take minus RA over here and dV over here. Now applying the limits and integrated, what will be the limits? At volume V is equal to 0, the initial volume, the initial conversion will be 0. At final volume V, the final conversion will be X. So finally we get V is equal to FA naught, which is obviously the constant value in this process, so that will come out of the integral, 0 to X dx over minus RA. So that is the design equation or the mole balance equation in terms of conversion for the plug flow reactor. Now just think about it, that what will be the change in terms of packed bed reactor. Obviously volume will be replaced by the weight of catalyst, and this minus RA will be replaced by minus RA prime, whose units are mole per gram of catalyst per time, while this minus RA has a unit of mole per volume of reactor per time. So going to the packed bed reactor, dFA over dW is equal to RA prime. Then similarly, FA is equal to FA naught minus FA naught X, taking differential with respect to W, and then rearranging it. The procedure is totally the same, only the terms are changing, that V is replaced by W and RA is replaced by Ra prime. And the similarly, the limits will be obviously different at W is equal to 0, X is equal to 0. At W is equal to W, X is equal to X. And finally, we get W is equal to F naught 0 to X, dx over minus Ra prime. So in summary, we will say that we have derived the four equations, or we have derived equation for each reactor. For batch reactor, it is in terms of time. For CSTR, in terms of volume. For PFR, in terms of volume. While for PBR, it is in terms of weight of catalyst. So that concludes our today's lecture related to the CRE, the chapter number 2. We have started it from the book Elements of Chemical Reaction Engineering by Fogler. So I hope you have enjoyed the lecture. If you have any feedback, any suggestion related to this lecture, please do share with me in the comment section. And that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos.